Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. It's me Anil and we are in the series of online job portal using ASP.NET. In previous video, that is part number 8, we have seen how a user can update his profile, and while updating profile they can upload their resumes also. Okay, so now in today's video, that is part number 9, we are going to display a job to the user in user panel. Okay, so we'll create a page. We already have created page for that. You can find that inside this menu, find our jobs. So this page is already created. Okay, so it's a static page, so we'll modify this page. Okay, the controls that we have to use here for displaying data from the database. Okay, so and here also we'll make some changes, like we want job locations but we don't want this job category, so we'll remove this drop down list and we'll move this job location at the top instead of here job category. Then job type will be there. Okay, and we'll remove this experience part and we'll add this one, post within the days. Okay, and we'll remove this filter, this filter job within that price range, we'll remove that. Okay, instead of that we'll take here two buttons, one for filter button and one for reset. Okay, and we'll remove this top image. Okay, so we'll remove that. Okay, let's go to the code. So the page name is job listing. Open that page. Okay, now just close this content. Okay, and select this whole content part. I'm copying code from this doc file. We'll copy the design part till here. Copy and paste it here. And see, this CSS part was not there. Now, just I have pasted here. Okay, and then we have removed the top image. Okay, and then here, as I said, at the top we'll take job location. For that we have taken here drop down list, and in that drop down list it will going to bind the data from the data source, from the database. Okay, using the SQL data source, so it will fetch data from there and going to add it in drop down list. Okay, so let's stop this debugging mode. Okay, now right now we don't have this event on the .cs page, so we're going to create it. Press control space bar, click on create new event, so it will create an event on the .cs page. Can see here the event has been created. and we need to take the connection string here, like this connection string that is present, that is from my previous project, okay, which I have developed earlier. From there I have copied this code, so I need to add the configuration again for this database connection. So I will go to design page. There is two error. Let me check that first. Okay, we'll see that afterward. Right now go to design page. Okay, so we have to add that function which I have used. That's why giving here error. Actually I have created this function in the code behind page and use in this designing page. Okay, so first we'll add this function in the code behind page. The first one is get image URL. So for that this is a function, so I'm just copying this code and I'm going to paste here in the code behind page. After this drop down selected index change event. Okay, so I'm pasting it here, save it. Now let's see here, there is only one error, that is for relative date function. So we'll add that also. After that we get this relative date function. Okay, so we'll copy here from start to here and okay, so we have selected and we'll copy this part and going to paste it after the previous function. Okay, just save it. Go to the design page. Can see there is now zero error. Okay, so as I said, I have to configure this connection string for this SQL data source. Okay, so if I have the connection string in my webdoc config file, I can give that connection string name over here, so we don't need to configure it again, or else you can configure in by the design page. Okay, so let me check in my webdoc config file whether it is there, but I know it's there because I have added the starting. And see here I have the connection string, the name of for the connection string is CS, that is correct. So we don't need to configure this again. Like if you want to configure it again, suppose some problem is there this code, okay, then you can just go to the design page. The head part. Okay, okay, I have made one mistake here. Like I have to take this while pasting the code, I have to select this header head part also, so which I didn't follow that. So let me cut this code from here, or can just remove this part from here. Okay, let's comment it out. Control KC, then make it one. Content one, and here the second one, which is third, to make it two. Okay, now save it. Now let's go to design page. Now we can find our design page working properly. Okay, now what we want, as I have to configure that SQL data source control for the connection string. So in the source code, I need to select this control SQL data source, then need to go to design page. So the SQL data source is now been highlighted. So just click on the smart tag icon, click on configure data source. Now here you will find the connection string which is already present in your web.config file. So I have having one connection string with the name CS, so I have to select that connection string here. Okay, if you don't find any connection string in your web.config file, then you can create a new connection on clicking on new connection button. Okay, so I will be using the existing one, that is CS. If you click on this connection string, you will find the connection string contained. You can see the data source, that is SQL Express, initial catalog, the database name is job portal. Next, now here you need to specify like which table you want to select here. It's a drop down for the country, so I have to select here country table, and which columns like I have to use here. I have to display only country name, and the value for that it should be there, the country name itself. Okay, so I just click selecting the only one column, that is country name, and click next. Can test the query whether it's been getting data from database. Yeah, so click on finish. So this is how we can configure SQL data source. Okay, so we have worked on this drop down list, we have created the event for this, and the data also, and to display data inside this drop down, we have configured this SQL data source also. Okay, now here I have taken checkbox list. Okay, this controls like we can add multiple checkbox. Okay, that's in the format of list, means more than two checkbox we can add here. Okay, so it's under the job type, and here in the list item it should be the same name, the item list item name should be same as we have already seen or taken in our in admin module, where while adding the new job, when admin add a new job, he need to select like the job type. Okay, there we have taken drop down list with this same value, like full time, part time, remote and freelance. Okay, so we the name should be same. Okay, then okay, we need to create this event, selected index change event. Right now we don't have this event in the code behind page, so we'll remove it and press control spacebar. So it asks to create a new event, so click on first one, enter. So it will go to create an event for us in the code behind page. If we click on that, you can see here the event has been generated. Okay, now let's check for the radio button list. I have taken here one radio button list. Okay, that is for this posted 15th. Okay, so your list of radio buttons will be there. Okay, so the first one is any, the second one today, last 2 days, last 3 days, last 5 days, last 10 days. So total 6 radio button is there here. Okay, and the value for that I've given like 0 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, now the one event is here taken on selected index change. Okay, so just remove this event and we'll create a new one. Create new event. Okay, so that event has been created here on the code behind page. The event which was already present here was generated in my previous project, so I have just copied the code from there and pasted here. So that's why the event is already generated here, but I pasted in here design page, not in this code behind page. So there is no event for that in the code behind page. So that's why I have to remove the existing event, generated event. Okay, and we'll generate all the controls event now after pasting the code in the design page. Okay, so we have done for this also. Okay, radio button list. Now, as I said, we'll going to take two button, one for filter and one for reset. Okay, so here one button is for filter, like when we select any like a drop down, or here the checkbox list, or this radio button list. If we select any one of them from these three controls, or three of them we can select, then we can select on the filter. It will go to filter the data present in the database. Okay, and will display in this page. Okay, so and after that the controls which has been selected. Okay, so if we want to reset, if we click on the reset button, it will go to reset the control selected data. Okay, I know you will not going to understand like while seeing this code, but once I will run this project, like you will able to understand like the design after seeing the design part. Okay, in the browser. So let me run this page in the browser. Press F5 to run this project. Here in my case, this default page, that is the home page of this user module, is open by default. Okay, means in the here Visual Studio I have opened the job listing page. If I run the project while I am on the job listing page, so in the browser it will going to run this page job listing. Okay, but I have set this default page as startup page. If you right click on default, you will get your option to set as start page. Okay, so after clicking on this, so whenever you want to run this project, it will going to open the default page first. Okay, so just click on this find a job. Here it says, okay, the button click event. So we have taken one link button, that is for filter. So we have not generated that event on click event for that. So let's close this first. Now here remove this event, press control space bar and go for this create new event. So the event has been generated. The code behind, remove this, save, and see this both event has been generated here. Okay, let's see any event we need to generate. Now let's run this project. You can see here the drop down is there for the job location. Okay, so all countries will go to display here from the database. Then, as I said, there is inside the job type. For the job type, there is a checkbox list. Okay, and that is like a full time, part time, whatever we select, it will auto post the data to the server. As I enable the auto post event, okay, as I have enabled the auto post is equal to true, so that's why when we click on any of these checkbox, it will going to refresh the page. Okay, and here within this posted within, I've taken here radio button list. Okay, so it's a radio button list, but I've used the CSS for this radio button list as well as for this this one checkbox list. I've used the CSS in the head part. Here you can see the head part of this content placeholder. I've used this first one styling, this first one style, that is for checkbox. Okay, and the second one, that is for radio button list. Okay, so this two style of code, that is CSS code, I've taken for this checkbox and this radio button list. Okay, and I have taken here one link for font awesome. The icon, the tick icon, it's a font awesome icon. Okay, for that I've used this link, CDL link of font awesome. Okay, then now what we want, like okay, first we'll going to display all the jobs here, then we'll try to filter based on the selection of country. Okay, then based on this job type, then posted within, then we'll work on filter and reset part. Okay, so let's stop this project, go to the job listing part. Here in page load event, I'm copying this part code from here and going to paste it just above the page load event. So we need to import the namespace for these classes, like for the SQL connection class, then for the data table class, then for the configuration manager class. Okay, so I've imported the three namespace right now, that is one for configuration, one for data, and one for data dot SQL client. Okay, now here I've taken one string variable str for the connection string. Okay, that is coming from the web.config file, and one variable of type integer, and I have initialized the value to zero. Okay, now the page load event will go to display data of the job. Okay, okay, so I have pasted the required code for this displaying the list of jobs. Okay, so that is this function, so job list. So I have called this function inside this page load event. First of all, it will check the the page is loaded in the browser for the first time or not. If it is loaded for the first time, then it will going to call this show job list function for displaying the jobs in the browser. Okay, so it will check here. Right now we'll comment this part. Control KC as well as here. Okay, so what it will do here, it will take first connection string, okay, in the connection SQL connection class. Then here I've taken one query. Okay, the query says select job ID, title, salary, job type, company name, company image, country, state, created date from job table. From job tables, all these columns I'm selecting for fetching the data from the job tables, and will display the data in the job page, okay, in the user panel. Okay, so we'll display these all these columns data in the browser from the job table. If you want, I can show the table as well, which I have here. Yeah, you can see this is job table, which I have had job ID, title, number of posts, description, qualification, experience. I have not taken all the columns to display here. Only selected columns I have taken. That is the job ID, title, and this list, etc. All this is there. So I have taken here the selected columns. Okay. So based on this query, it will going to get data. Okay. So the query will come inside the SQL command, and the SQL command will going to come inside this SQL data editor class. Okay, so it will get the select query and as well as the connection string in this SQL adapter class. Now I have taken one data table, like to fill data in the data table. So when the query going to execute, it will get some data. Okay, so it will go to store temporarily in this data table object DT. Now we'll going to bind that data to the data list control. So where we have taken this data list control, so let's see. Here, data list control. Okay, so the ID is here, data list one. Okay, so based on that, I want to display the company image. Okay, so the from the column company image, we will going to get data from here. Okay, and based on that, it will going to display. And here I have taken one function, get image URL. So pass that this column image company image data inside this function get image URL. So what will it will do here, this function, press F12, it will take us to this function in the code behind page. Okay, so here it will get the data, like the company image data column data inside this object URL. Okay, now it will check that whether this URL have any value or it is null. Okay, so if it is null, that means there is no image uploaded for this the job right now we are working on, the data of the job, that job, the data of the selected job. Okay, so if that job didn't have any image or logo for the company, okay, so that at that time we need to display a default image for that job. Like I have one image that is no image, so the text will be display on that image, that is no image is there. Okay, so that default image I am going to display if which of the jobs didn't have any logo of the company or image of the company. Okay, so at that time it will going to take this path, image path of this no image dot png. Okay, if it has any data in the database, then it will going to pass in this like URL one string variable, and we'll going to pass here, and we'll return it that path. Okay, so and that part will going to come inside this attribute src. Okay, so it will going to display that image. Okay, now same for here. Then title, the job post name will display here inside the title, then the company name, then which state, country, the salary will going to display like that way, and the date, yeah, how many hours ago the job has been posted or created by the admin. So how that will going to display, so we'll get a data, that is data when the job is created from the created date column. Okay, so okay, I think create date is there. Let me check here. Create date is there. Okay, let me check in the database. Yeah, the column name is create date. Okay, so I've just made the correction over here, as well as here in the design page also. Okay, so we'll get the data of this from the table, right? But we need to convert that into like 3 hours ago, 1 minute ago, 2 minute ago, 6 hour ago, 1 day ago. Like that way, we have one function, relative date function. Okay, so we'll pass that value into this function as a parameter. So this function is here. When we click on F2, well, it will take to this function. Okay, so it takes the argument parameter, you can say, which is we are passing that column value. Okay, so based on that, it will going to convert into the time ago. Okay, so I have picked this code from this stackoverflow.com website. Okay, there is a lot of code present on the Stack Overflow, but I found this code useful according to my project. Okay, okay, you can see I will going to provide this the code link in the description. I will provide one file. Okay, and the file contains the design part. Okay, it will contain the whole code of this design page, as I know, like it's been hard to create for the design or design this page. Okay, so that's why I am going to provide this design code, as well as this one relative date function code, and I think yeah, that's it. So we'll provide that whole design code, and for this code behind page, I will provide the code, that is this function relative date. Okay, rest of the code you have to type it by own. Okay, now yeah, just before displaying this jobs inside the data list control, we have taken here one label control for displaying the count, job count. When job is being displayed in this control, data list one control, how many jobs present at that time, it will get the count of that job and will display in this label control. So for displaying that data, this label control, I have taken here one function, that is job count, this one. So what will it will do here? So the job count function, I will send this data, like that is coming from the data table object, dt.rows.count, the count value, that is an integer. So I have passed here the integer value inside this job count function, so it will check that whether it is greater than 1, then it will return the value. So here the text, the first text is there, total, then I have taken here HTML bold, then the value of the count, that like how many count is there, one or two or three, whatever. So it will going to be highlighted in the bold. Then job found, total, let's suppose two is there, total two jobs found. So it will display like this way. If it is greater than one, if it is greater than one, if it is equal to one, okay, what happens when it is one, then it will display total one job found. So now what is the difference here for the first one and the second one? In the first one, it will get it is here, you can see jobs, and here job, here more than one job will there, so jobs have taken, and here only one job is there, so I have to take here job, not jobs, okay. So that's why we have taken here two separate. And what happens when there is no job, that means zero count is there, at that time it will going to display no job found, okay. So based on that, this job count function return the value to this label control, okay, and display that value in the label control, okay. And what I need to say, I explain this function get image URL and this relative date for converting the time and date into like hour, how many hours ago, minute ago, day ago, okay. So it will display data like that way. And for this one, yeah, radio RB, that is radio button selected color change. In the design page, you have seen that the radio button I have taken, radio button list, that is any 2 days ago, 3 days ago, like that way. So not 3 days ago, let me check here in this design page. Today, any, first one is any, today, last 2 days, last 3 days. So this is a radio button list. So what happens, like to give the CSS code, I've used the CSS code, okay, in the header part of this content placeholder of this job listing page. But what happens, some issues were there after selecting the radio button, okay. Means if I selected the first one, I need to change the color also, with that indicate which one I have selected right now. For that, I have used this function, okay. So it will check that if the radio button list is been selected, if one, any of the item is been selected, means here true, if it's selected, then I will add here class, like class value, we'll add one class with this name, okay. And this I have used in the CSS part of this in the design page, okay. So based on that, it will go to change the color of the selected radio button list, okay. So that's we have to call inside this page load event here, okay. Now let me show in the browser. So let's run by clicking here or by pressing F5 or just press Control F5. Let's close the first one, find a job. Now you can see here, okay, for this one I didn't uploaded any image for this job. So as I said, it will going to display one default image which will display text on it, like no image, but I have don't provided that image in my images folder of the project, so that's why I didn't find that path, the image in that given path. So unable to display here. If you click on right click on here, click on inspect, you will find the path here. Yeah, images within the images folder, no image.png. There is no image present with this name inside this images folder. Okay, so that's why it's not displaying. But afterward I will going to add it. Right now you can see I have total five jobs. Okay, the first one, that is for web developer, app developer, front end, back end software. Okay, so can see if I hover on this this job type link button. So at the bottom, left side, can see the link is been showing localhost user job details dot axps question mark id is equals to 4. Can find the id of the job here, 4 3 2 1. So what why I have taken that, if we click on this, so based on the id it will going to display the details of this particular job, the job details page. Okay, let me show that code in these job listing design page. You will get a clear idea about it here. This one, job type here. So I've taken here one higher anchor tag. In that I'm displaying the job type, this one. This full time, part time, freelance, remote, all this job type taken inside this anchor tag. So inside this anchor tag, I have given the page name, job details. Right now we didn't create this page. I think we created, yeah, job details. We have already created because we just copied the template. We have integrated the template in our project. So we are right. So that's why we have created all the pages. Okay, but there is, but it's static page. Okay, so based on this ID, the job ID, it will going to take us to that page, and based on the job ID we'll going to display the details of that this particular job on the job details page. So that's why I have taken here this HRF for getting the job ID when we click on the this anchor tag for this job type. So the same way I have taken for this job title. When we hover on this job title, we can see at the bottom left again the link is generated as link generated for this job type button. And here also right now there is no image, you can see here. When I hover on this image again, the link is generated at the bottom right, at the bottom left. When when I hover on this job anywhere, it will not going to generate, only it will going to generate that link when we hover on this image, job title as and the job type. On the three I can click to get the job details. When I click on this, it will take me to the job details page with the ID one, but right now it will not going to display any data for that because it's a static data for which I've used here. So it will display the same data for every jobs right now. So we'll modify that in the next video. Right now yeah, you can see this one, this the part, 4 days ago, yesterday, 2 days ago, 3 days ago, and the 5 days ago. And here we'll display the state and the country. Okay, can see here the design page, first state will going to display, then the country will going to display, then the salary will going to display here. Can see here the salary, the salary data is 18,000 per month. And here for this company name, ABC Infotech Private Limited, so the company name will taken here. And the title, title. So when we hover on this title, there is links generated at the bottom left side. So how that coming? Because we have taken that title inside this anchor tag. An anchor tag, I have taken the page name which I have already here in our project with the job ID, okay, passing with the query string. So the same for this company image, then job title, then for this job type, these three link created for getting the job details when we click on it. Okay, so based on that, the data is displayed here. So right now I have to add the default image which is right now not displaying here. So I have to take that, and then we'll work on this drop down. Based on the selected drop down data, it will go to filter this data here. Okay, so let's stop this project. So I've copied the image. I'm going to paste here inside this images folder. Paste. Can see no_image.png. So this is the image which I am talking about. So when we run on the next time, it will going to display. Now we need to work on the drop down change event. When we click on the drop down, when we select the drop down data, so based on that it should change and display data accordingly. Okay, so here is the drop down. So we'll work on this. So I have just copied the code from my doc file, then need to make sure the column name is create date, or whatever column name you have taken in your database or tables. So make sure it should be same. Okay, save it. So what we'll here do, it will check the selected value of the drop down. If it is not equal to 0, means that at zero what data it's been there for the drop down list. Let's check. In drop down list value 0, at 0 country data will go to there display. Okay, so at the by default, the first the country is been selected. When we click on the drop down, so the country selected and the rest of data of the country will go to display just below this country. Okay, so by default the country is selected, that means there is no country right now selected specifically. Okay, so that's why we need to check for this, like if the 0 is not selected, that means we have selected any specific country from the drop down list. So based on that, we'll go to fetch data here. So from the job table, based on the condition where country, the selected item, the selected value on the drop down list will come to fetch, and that will come here for this country column, and based on that it will going to get the data and will get this all this ID, all these columns data. Okay, all this column that we have already taken here in the job list, the column name is same. Okay, the query is also same, just need to add here the where condition, that is for country, because we are working on this drop down list country. Okay, so if the value selected means a specific country selected, at that time it will going to fetch data from there and going to bind in the this one DT. Okay, so in DT it will going to bind. Okay, but how it will going to display in this job list, that is data list control. For that, what I have taken here, this part. So let me uncomment this part, control KU, as well as this one. So here it will check. I have called this function here also. So job list, after fill in the data to this. Okay, so now can now I have the data filled in this DT object. I have taken this DT object as globally here. Can see it's been highlighted because I have taken this globally. Okay, so here while displaying this data means while we call this function, at that time it will check the DT is null. That means when the page is loaded for the first time, at that time this object DT it has null value, means there is no data present at that time. So at that time it will go to fetch data from this query from the database. It will go to fetch data and going to bind it in this data list. Okay, but if we click on the any control like drop down, radio button or checkbox, at that time the page got refreshed, right? So at that time we'll call this function again. At that time it will check the data is null. No, at that time the data table object has some value, so it will not going to execute this if log. Okay, it will not going to execute this if log. So it already has value inside this DT, so it will go to add inside the data list control. Okay, and the count will going to display in the label LBL job count. So let's run and see in the browser, because if it is selected means that if it is greater than 0 means any specific country selected, at that time it will go to fetch data based on that from the database, or else it will go to display the existing data, means the list of jobs will display here. Okay, so let's run Control F5. Okay, so let's see here in the find job page. Now can see the country here, India, here US, United States. Only one data for this US, so we'll filter here US. I have selected here US, that is United States. So based on that, only one data is there, so it displayed only one data here. Okay, and the count can see total one job, not jobs, total one job found. Okay, so that's mean it's working fine here, as well as this drop down selection value change. Okay, that filter part is also working. If we select on this like India, four job will be there, because total we have five jobs. One job is that is for USA, and the rest of the four job is for India. Can see here the four, now this time jobs there. Okay, total four jobs found. So based on that count and the data here change dynamically. Okay, now can see other four job is there. That means this drop down part is working properly. Now we'll go for this checkbox, that is the job type. Based on the job type, it will going to display like this. It is a full time, part time, remote, freelance, whatever. Okay, so based on the job type, it will going to display that. Okay, so let's stop that. So let's find this one checkbox list event. Okay, that is selected index change event. Okay, so what I have taken here inside this event, one variable, string variable. Okay, it's an empty at the start, it has empty value, and inside that I've called one function, selected checkbox. We click on F2, well, it will take to that function here, just below that function. So what it will do here inside this function, so again here I have taken one string variable, the job type, the name job type, and the value is empty, the starting. And here I have taken one for loop. Why for loop? Because the checklist, the checkbox list is a list. Okay, so that means we can select As we know, like for these checkbox, we can select multiple checkbox at the time. Okay, so that means multiple item is being selected. So that's why we need to like loop that data to get the put every data format. Okay, so that's why based on that count, it will go to inside this for loop. How many count, like how many data is been selected in the checkbox list. Okay, so it will the first one, that is zero, at the zero, at the zero time, the means that is the first time. Okay, so it will fetch the selected data and going to add in this variable, that is string job time. So it will going to add here with the comma at the end. It will append comma inside this job type variable, means the first one, the first value has been selected. Let me show in the design page the first one, that is full time. Okay, the checkbox list, the first one, that is full time. If the first one is selected, that is full time, after that one comma will be added. Okay, now it will go into again in the loop, for loop. Now it will check if any other data has been selected. So let's say that is the remote is selected, so second one. So then it will at the first, what data is present in this job, that is the full time and comma, full time comma. Then now this time it will going to add the third one, that is remote comma. Okay, so now the data present in this job type is now let me show here the comment. The first full time comma, so at the first the data we have stored, it was like full time, then comma at the end it was added. Now again it will going to loop in this for loop, and now this time it will going to add data remote, again comma is there. Okay, so now the actual data is this one, full time comma remote comma. Okay, so now I need to remove this the comma which is present at the end. So that's why I have taken here this one, the variable name dot trim end will it will trim, means remove the end one, end part. Which one? The comma part. Will remove the comma which is present in the end. Okay, so now right now we'll have only this part. Okay, full time comma remote. So this variable contains full time comma remote. That means I have selected two checkbox, that is for first one and the third one. Okay, so based on that it will going to display data here. So here it will get data in the job type. Okay, now it will check if it is not null. That means if single, or means at least one data has been selected of the checkbox or not. So it will check here. If it is not null, means at least one or more data has been selected in the checkbox list. So based on that, here the query will be same. Just here in the where condition we need to change the column job type. At the previous we are fetching for the country, so that's why the column country is there. Okay, now we are working on the job type, so that's why we have taken this job type column name, and we have to find from the selected. So it will we have to use here in operator. So based on that, the data it will get the from the job type and display in this what we can say, the function calling data list control. Okay, so based on that it will going to display. So let's save it and run in the browser. Close this one, find a job. If we click on the, let's check the full time one, two job is there for the full time, one job is for freelance, one for remote, one for part time. Okay, means every job is there once, but the full time job we have two times. Okay, so if we click on this full time, only two job will going to display, but it's error. Okay, as I said, like in my previous project, it has column name created date, but in this project, like we are working on this right now, it's the column name, it has create date, so that's why it's given error to me. So let's remove this one, save it and refresh, continue. Okay, enter, we'll refresh the page. Yeah, you can see this image, no image available, there is no logo has been added for this job, so that's why we have taken the default image that we're going to display here, that indicate there is no image present for this job. Okay, so we click on the full time job. Okay, I think stop it. Now I have to run it again, control F5. Full time, now it's work. So the full time we have only two jobs, so it's displayed here, total two jobs count here displayed. And for the part time, if we remove this and select the part time, there is only one job for the part time. And we right now we selected the part time. If we select on this full time, then there will be three data, means one job for this part time and two jobs for this full time. Okay, we click on this, you can see two data is displayed for this full time, first and second, and the third one, that is for part time. Okay, if we click on this remote, it will display one more job, that is count four. There will be four jobs. Okay, that is here part time. If I remove this full time, then there will be two jobs, one for remote and one for part time. Okay, so it means it works properly and perfectly. Can see here part time and freelance. So it's here freelance and part time. Okay, so based on that we'll going to display. So the country is been working, the job time and the job type is also working. Now let's do for this posted within. Okay, like based on how many days ago, so it will work here. Okay, so let's stop this. That is radio button list. Okay, so when the event is called, okay, when the user click on the radio button, that at that time this event will going to call, and it will check first of all like the radio button is been selected or not. This like condition is not equal to zero. If we see on the design page for the radio button list here, can see this one radio button list, the first one, that the value is zero, that is any. Okay, that means by default it will going to selected here. Okay, and that means it is selected, it means there is no condition applied for the filtration based on this radio button list. Okay, if we click on this today, last to date, at that time filtration will apply for the displaying of the job. Okay, so that means at the zero there we don't need to get to display any data, filtration data. Okay, so we need to check here whether the radio button has selected any value or not. Zero here indicate that means there is no data has been selected in the radio button list. Okay, so that means if it is selected any value not equal to zero, that means if it is selected any value, so first of all we have taken one string variable with the name posted date, and the value is been empty starting, and now we'll add the value to this posted data from this selected radio button has been seen already saw that in this checkbox for that we have taken one function, separate function. Okay, so like that way, same for this also we have created separate function, but the function totally different here. Can see this one selected radio button. So again you have taken one variable string posted date, which is with empty data, and you have taken one class date time and the object date and the data displaying today's date. Okay, so it will get the data inside this date object with the today's date. Okay, now here it will check if the selected value is equals to 1. The 1, what is the text value? That is today. 1, that is today. If the today, that means the current date. Okay, so the date having the today's value. Okay, so it will just format the date into this year, month and day. Okay, so it will going to format the date into this format, and for this SQL date we have here, that will going to convert into date type. Okay, whatever date will going to come, will going to convert into this date type in the SQL. Okay, so it's a SQL query. So this will going to add afterward in the bigger query, like the actual query where we will going to display. So here this is actual query, this is actual query, and based on the condition it will going to concatenate the rest of the query. Okay, so the first one it will going to take here, convert the date into date format. Okay, that is a today's date. Okay, so it will going to format, so based on that it will going to display today's data, that is from the column create date. Okay, for the create date it will going to fetch and based on that it will going to display all the columns data. So if it is selected 1, and if what happens if it selected 2, means that is 2 days ago, that means from the current date 2 days back. So that's why we have taken date time dot now add days. So it will with this add days function we can add how many days later or back we have to get the day value. Okay, so just 2 days before. Okay, 2 days ago, so that's why I have given here minus 2. So it will take the actual value from the now today's value, so it will minus 2, so it will subtract 2, it will going to subtract 2 from the current date. Okay, so that's why it will get the data, but what I am taking here between SQL operator, between, like it will get from this first one, that is 2 days ago, the date 2 days ago, and the current date and the current date. Okay, so in between the 2 days ago, like today is 17, that means 2 days ago, that is 15, from 15 to 17, and today's date here 17, and the 2 days ago the date is 15. So they are, that means from 15 to 17 how many data has been posted. So it will fetch the data and going to display, okay, in the data list control. Okay, so like that way it will create a condition and will get the value based on the condition. So that's why same for this 3 days ago, 5 days ago, minus 5, 10 days ago, minus 10. So rest of the query is same. Can see the query is same here. The here it will for this today's date. At the end here can see, after and can find here the same, that is for today's date. Okay, this part get the data of today's date, and the, at the here it's also the same, but only here number of days change. Okay, like we have here last 2 days, last 3 days, last 5, 10, 2, 3, 5, 10. So based on that, we have taken here -2, -3, -5, -10. So based on that, it will going to return the value stored in this posted date variable. So it will return this variable. Okay, so it contains value inside it. So we'll going to get that value and store inside this posted date variable inside this event. Okay, so now we have got this the particular condition data here. Okay, now based on this condition, it will going to get the data from the database, and now it will going to fetch that data and fill in the DT object, and we'll going to display in the data list control. Okay, so now let's see. Press Control F5, we'll see in the browser. Close this, find a job. Right now, as I said, the first one, any will be selected. That means there will be no filtration going to apply. Okay, if I click on today, there is no job added today, so it will not going to display any job here. So that will display no job found. Okay, if I select here last 2 days, can see here only one data we can select at a time. That means it's a radio button. In a radio button, we can select only one item at a time, but in checkbox we can select multiple items at a time. Okay, so now what says here, last 2 days only we have one record, like yesterday. In between that, it will go to fetch the data, that is yesterday. If we click on any, it will going to display all the data. Okay, so 2 days ago, it was 2 days ago, and I have taken here last 2 days, that means 2 days and yesterday. Okay, so there is no data for today. That means we'll display only yesterday's data, right? If you want to check, let's add one more job in the admin panel. So let's log in with the admin. And what happens? Login. So here, job list, we have 5 jobs. Now let's add one job. So I've added one job. Okay, can see here the job list. So it will come to display the next page, and see this one. Click on edit. You can see the data I have added here. Okay, so we didn't implement this logout functionality. So let's go inside this page called user default. Enter. So it will open this user panel, and here inside this find a job, you can see this last one jobs right now we have added, that is 42 seconds ago. And see now if I filter this last 2 days, can see two records is been displayed. It will consider from today, that means last 2 days, that is today, that first one today, and the second one, that is yesterday. So it will going to display only two jobs based on that. So that is today's job and yesterday's job. Okay, so like that way, if I select last 3 days, then 3 job is there, like yesterday, 2 days ago, and a minute ago. Okay, 5 days ago. So in 5 days ago, 5 job is displayed. Okay, and 10, it will display all the 6 jobs. Okay, so that means it's working here properly. Now what I want now, that if I select a country, India, so can see right now we have four or five jobs. Sorry, if I select here US, okay, so only one job is there. But if what happens if I select okay, let's select here India only. India, we have five jobs, right? But I want to find only full-time jobs in India. So can see there is two jobs in full-time, right? For the US, which type job type is freelance. Okay, if I select India and I select here this one freelance, can see the data I've got freelance, which is correct. Okay, but the country says here US, but I've selected here India. So for that, for this problem, I have taken this button filter. If I click on this filter, so it will fetch the data according to this drop down as well as this job type, that is country and the freelance job type. Okay, so based on this it will go to fetch data and go to display here. If it is selected here any this posted within also, so it will base display data based on that also. Okay, if I want to click on reset, so it will go to reset, means it will go to unselect the freelance and the in country will go to select the country. Okay, so based on that, like it will go to work for the reset and filter. So we'll do it now. Okay, so let's stop it. So let's first do this filter reset part. Okay, then we'll go for the filter one. Button click event here inside this I have taken try and catch block, try catch and final block. Okay, and the try block I have taken some variables like boolean string and one dictionary, sorry, one list. Okay, one list and the condition string. Okay, so after that, so when we click on filter button, so it will check for three of the controls like which I have used in the design, like for the first one, that is drop down, that is for country. Second one, checkbox list for this job type. Third one, red button list for the posted within. Okay, so three of the controls we need to check in the filter button, right? So first one, it will check for this country because we have first one the drop down country. Okay, so first it will check for this country, so whether it will whether which one value is selected, means if it is greater than zero, it has any value selected, a specific country selected, right? So it will find the data and go to add in this query list. It's a list. Okay, so it will go to add a list of data to this variable list. Okay, so first it will going to add like country is equals to whatever the selected country will going to come here. Okay, like country is equals to the first one India, country is equals to India will store in this variable query list. Okay, and the condition here it will going to true, this condition is set to true, means any of these will selected, like the first one is for drop down, second one is for checkbox, third one is for, can see here, third one is for radio button. If the third one, all the three of the all the three is selected, then it will come inside this if part, whether each condition is true. If any of them is any one of the selected, then at that time each condition boolean is set to true. Based on the condition, it will go to this fire this query part. Okay, so now let's see this the checkbox part. Okay, we have already created this function. Okay, just press F12, it will take us to that function. So based on that, it will the selected items for the checkbox rate, it will go to get in this job tag by adding comma. Okay, like that way it will going to get the data inside this and will return that data here, and will store that data inside. Okay, and it will there. So at that, based on that, it will going to store data here in the job type variable. So first of all, we need to check whether it's empty or not. If it's not, then it will going to add that job type in. It will search in the column job type. In means your operator, like in which how many data has been there, like two data has been there from the two of them, like in the job type column, two of them record is been there or not. So based on that, it will going to fetch a data from the tables. Okay, so this is for the checkbox, that is job type. The first one, that is drop down, that is from the country column. Okay, and the third one, that is your, if the radio button is selected, okay, then at that time it will call this function. If we click on F12, it will take us to that function. So here it's a function. So based on the which radio button is been selected, based on that this condition will going to change accordingly. Okay, we have already seen this function, so we're not going to waste on this time. So based on that, it will going to store the value in this posted data. After that, it will going to add in this list of query, the variable query list. Okay, so it's for created date column. In our case, it is create date column. Okay, so it will search in the column create date, the date which we get, like between the date between, if it is selected the first one today, so there is no between condition added in the query, like it will get simply for that present date. Okay, but if it's if it is like a previous date data, like 2 days ago, 3 days ago, 5 days ago, 10 days ago, so it will like call the data between operator by using the between SQL operator. Based on that, it will going to get the data here. Okay, so every time in every controls, like we have put the condition, each condition is true. If it is called, means any data is selected for the drop down, each condition will set to true, and same for this job type, like for the checkbox list, if it is selected, this condition should will going to set to true. If the radio button is selected, this condition will set to true. Okay, so now after that, it will check if this boolean variable is condition is equal to true, then only it going to come inside this block. Okay, so here it will check as I said, it's this one, the query list is a type of list of string. Okay, so that means if the drop down list is selected as well as checkbox is also selected, at that time that means we have two records inside this variable. Okay, the first one is for country, the second one is for this one, job type. Okay, now so we have two list of data in this query list. So now we need to loop the data. Okay, so it will find the first one in this variable A. Okay, the string A, it will get the first record, that is for the country, the first one, that is country. Suppose we have selected the country, okay, from the drop down list, so the first one it will going to get, that is country. Okay, then it will going to add or append, concatenate. Okay, so it will concatenate, and after that means the data country is equals to India. If suppose in this country India is selected, country is equal to India, and okay, let me show here the example. So it will be in string format, so should be single code. Okay, then and we'll go to add. So now data will store in this subquery like this way. Data will store in this subquery variable like this way. Country is equals to India and okay. Now if suppose if this checkbox is also selected, the checkbox the first one that is for full time. Okay, job type in that is full time. Okay, so we'll going to add after that. Okay, so let me show you job type in single quotes full time. If you have selected two data like a one part-time job, so it will come like this way. Okay, so now the data stored in this subquery will be like this way. Country is equals to India and job type in full time comma part time. Okay, so I think it should be in bracket. Yeah, this should be in bracket. Okay, so based on that this condition will going to form here and will going to store here in the inside this subquery. Okay, now after this it will going to add and at the end, because whatever the value present after that it will going to append concatenate this and value also here. So after that and will going to come here. Now the actual value will be this one. Okay, now what we want, I want to remove this and which is present at the end. So for that, when we come out of this for each loop, okay, so I have taken a for each loop, that means how many data means whatever the count is present in this query list variable, it will go into every time in a loop until and unless the list of jobs get empty. Okay, till that it will go into this for each loop, then we'll going to come out. Okay, then what happens, now we need to remove this and part. Okay, so for that like we have to remove from this variable, right, from this variable's data. So we'll take this variable dot remove. What it will going to remove, the remove function here, it will takes here, you can see here first argument, the first parameter it takes here the start index, the second one is count. Okay, so start index means from where it will going to start to remove, that is like we need to pass this the index of this. Okay, from here for the end, just before a of the end, we need to pass that index of that a. Okay, so how we can find that? Okay, so we need to find the index of just before a which is present inside this subquery, right? So that's why we going to use here subquery dot last index of. So it will get the index but which is from the last. Okay, from the last we want, right? But here which one we want, so we'll use here and, so it will find the index of this and value inside this subquery. So now we get the index like here for this one. So here it will get the index, and from there we'll give the count, how many count from there we'll going to, we have to remove 3, 1 a 1 and 2 d 3. So 3 that is and has 3 total, okay, right, total count 3. So that's why we have given here 3. So it will going to remove from this till here. So it will be going to remove and completely from this data subquery. Now we'll have only this data. Okay, so now based on that it will going to append here on the where condition in the query will be here like this way. The query is select column name from the jobs where country is close to India and the job type in full time and part time. So based on that, we'll go to fetch the data from the database, and if it's not selected any of the controls, then it will going to display as usual data from the job. That means list of all jobs we're going to display. Okay, so based on that, we're going to fill the data and going to display in the data list control. Okay, if it is fine any exception, it will going to catch in your the catch block, and finally block, it will going to close our connection, database connection. Okay, so here the reset part. The reset button is left. In reset, we need to reset all the controls. All controls means the three controls that we have used. The first one, that is country drop down list. So we need to clear that selection. The second one is checkbox. So we'll clear that selection. But also the third one, that is the radio button list. So we need to clear that also. That is the zero. We will going to select, that is any. Okay, the data any. The zero index. Then we need to make sure the color is being changed for the selected part. That's why we call this function. And we need to display the job, the list of all jobs from the database. So that's why we have called this function also. Okay, so now let's save it and press Ctrl F5. Now let's select here India, and we'll select remote. We'll select here remote. Now we'll click on filter. Can see it's the country India, and for the remote is being displayed here. Okay, if I just remove this part, the mode. What if we click on freelance, and freelance, that is for country US, and we have selected here India. So if we click on freelance and click on filter button, so can see still get this data. We have selected a country India, but still we get data for this. Okay, we need to debug it. So for that, we need to stop and click here or press F5 so that we can debug it. Okay, let's add breakpoint on the filter button, click event here. Let's select India and click here freelance. Now click on filter. So cursor has been stopped here at the button click event. Press F10 so it will move forward. So now it will check here the selected value is India. Okay, so that means the country here, the value stored here, the query list, that is country is equals to India, right? Then it will check for this one selected checkbox. Okay, press F11 so it will go to inside this function. Okay, what it says here, the item selected. Okay, the first one, the first item is not selected, so it will go to comes inside this loop. The second also is not selected, third is also not selected, but the fourth one is selected, right? Fourth one is selected, so that's why it's come inside this, and the text for this freelance. Okay, so we get the freelance value. Okay, job type value freelance, but after the freelance we can see there is comma present. It open this and see comma is present. Okay, so we have to remove this comma, so it will going to trim at the end. So it is going to remove this comma from that. Now you can see in the job type only freelance is there. There is no comma. Now we get the job type as freelance. Okay, and the country we get the India. Okay, country we get India, and the job type we get freelance. But right now we need to add in this condition job type. Okay, so it will going to add here the job type is freelance. So I can see in the query list there is two data, that is country is equals to India and the job in freelance. Okay, that we want. So we'll check for this radio button, that is not present right now. So it's true, is condition, yeah, is true. So it will go to inside this loop is condition, and it going to inside, now it will go inside this for each loop, because we have two record in for this query list. So now at A we have the first one, that is zero index data. Okay, that is the country is equals to India. So after that it will going to add and country is equals to India, it will going to add, and I can see the value inside this subquery country is equals to India and. Okay, now again it will going to inside this for each. Now this time A contains the value job type in freelance, that is the second one from the list. Okay, so now it will going to concatenate inside this existing data with that, and the let's see here you can see the country is equals to India and job type in freelance, and at the end we have extra and, so we need to remove that also. So by this it will going to remove and from that. Okay, now you can see here there is no and at the end. Okay, so we have get the part of this condition that we want to add, we are going to add in the query, actual query. Okay, so let's check here what query it forms here. Select all, copy, let's open our database. Let's check a new query. Okay, make sure job portal, your database has been selected here, paste. Okay, because of this the column name created date is there, so that's why we didn't get the actual value. Now it's been proper. If we click on it and run, there will be no data present. Okay, so that means it's working properly. We just need to rename here the column name, that's it. So we'll take this, move back one step back. Okay, and we'll remove the D here and save it. Now let's press F10. Now let's see the query contains created. Okay, so now it will get the data, actual data, sorry, no data will be there. You can see no job form. Now it's working properly. Just remove this breakpoint which I have added here, or the this filter click event. Now if I remove this freelance, if I click on the full time, there is two job for the full time in India. Okay, so it will display only two records. So we click on filter, can see only two records is there. Okay, now what if I click on this last 3 days, but it will not going to get this one. Okay, let's see last 3 days and click on filter, there is no job present. If we click on the last 5 days and we click on filter, now we'll get that record which is 3 days ago. Okay, the 3 days ago that I will consider that from the today itself. Today is the one, okay, and the yesterday is the second, the day yesterday is the third one, okay. If we click on 10, then two jobs will get here. We click on filter, two jobs is there, 5 days ago and 3 days ago. So based on that, it will filter here, okay. And like we have seen all the filters here. Now we click on reset, it will going to reset the control. Here country is selected, which is default one, and here then the selected is been unchecked here. Now here the last 10 days is selected now, and is the default one is selected, okay. That means it's working properly, this the job listing page part, okay. So so in the next video we'll create we'll see for the details of the jobs, okay. We'll create a page, we have already a page for that, but we'll change some code in the design, and we'll implement the code behind page for that, the code the this one, the job details part, okay. So we'll implement in the next video, so we'll meet in the next video. So we'll meet in the next video. Till then, bye. Take care. Thank you for watching.